Okay, today we are going to do that problem of the previous class, as well as we will be talking about standard deduction. We will be talking about standard deduction, entertainment allowance, and professional tax, and we will try to do a problem. Okay, let's start. So this was the problem which we were doing, and we could not complete because of the circumstances. Now let's start the problem. Okay, the problem is in front of you. So already we have dealt twice, so we will now just calculate one by one. Okay, so basic salary, the rule is whatever is the amount which is given by the employer to the employee, it is fully taxable. So I have kept it on the amount column of taxable. Next one is dearness allowance. The rule is it is fully taxable. So 2000 is what is given. So 2000 into 12 months, 24,000 is fully taxable. Next one is commission. The rule for commission is it is fully taxable. You can write here also, you can make a column like fully taxable, like that. Okay, so 10 lakhs into 1% is equal to 10,000 rupees is the commission earned by the employee and received from the employer. So 10,000 is the rule, is fully taxable. Bonus, it is given here 32,000. So bonus is given for the whole year, not per month. So the rule is fully taxable. So I have written it as fully taxable, and all the amount is taken on the amount column. Next one is HRA. So HRA, there is a rule. First and foremost, you have to find out where this guy is working. This guy is working in Bombay. So the rule is 50% of salary, number one. Number two, rent paid minus 10% of salary. Number three is actual HRA received. So we will calculate this in the next slide. I will show you how the calculations are done. But you remember that he is working in Bombay, number one. Number two, the actual allowance received is 1,000 rupees per month, and the rent paid by the employee to the owner of the house is 1,200 per month. Okay. Next one. So we will see in the next, there is a working notes for here in the next slide. Next one is entertainment allowance. Please remember, in case of a private employee, entertainment allowance, whatever is amount received, it is fully taxable. So 1,000 rupees is what is given. So 1,000 rupees into 12 is 12,000 rupees is fully taxable. So I have written fully taxable. Next one is children's educational allowance. Children's educational allowance. So what is the rule? The rule is he can give 100 rupees per month per child to a maximum of two children. एक एक को 100 रुपया मिल सकता है, ऐसा दो लड़कों को मिल सकता है, तो 100 रुपया मिल सकता है. सो 100 रुपया पर मंथ मिलेगा, और उसको कितने बच्चे हैं? इट इज गिवन इन द प्रॉब्लम दैट ही हैज टू चिल्ड्रन. सो पर मंथ ही कैन बी गिवन 200 रुपीज. 100 इंटू टू 200 रुपीज पर मंथ इंटू 12 मंथ. सो हाउ मच ही कैन बी गिवन? 2400 इज टू बी गिवन. बट this fellow, the employee is giving how much to him? 5,000. So he is receiving 500 per month. So he is receiving 6,000 for the full year. Now already I have calculated, this is exempted from tax. So this is exempted from tax. 2400 is exempted from tax. So the rule says that if you have one children, 100 rupees. If you are having two children, he can give 200 per month. So 2400, it can be exempted maximum, provided that he has two children. Now how much he has given? He has given 6,000. But how much is exempted? This much is exempted. So what is the difference? 3,600. So income is this much, this is the exemption, the difference is this much, and the rule is it is fully taxable. So this is taxable. So not 6,000 is taxable, only 3,600 is taxable. This is the exemption. This is the children's educational allowance. Next one is transport allowance. In the last class, I told you that the transport allowance is for office to home and home to office. So जो पेट्रोल का खर्चा होता है वो employer employee को देता है. So the rule is here, the maximum he can give per month is 800, which is exempted. So this much is exempted, per month, but how much he has given? 1,000 rupees. So how much is the difference? 1,000 is receiving, but exemption is only 800 rupees. So over and above 800 is 200. So 200 per month is taxable. 200 into 12 is equal to 2,400. So 2,400 is fully is taxable. So even though he has received 12,000, even though he has received 12,000, exemption is 800 into 12, 9,600. So difference is 2,400. That is taxable. So this is the way you calculate the transport allowance. Next one is medical allowance. Already I told in the very first two, three classes that any allowance of the name medical allowance is given by the employer to the employee, the rule is fully taxable. So 500 into 12 is equal to 6,000 rupees into 6,000 rupees is equal to, it is fully taxable. It is fully taxable. So I have kept it here. Next one is servant allowance. Servant allowance is 2,400, 200 per month, 200 per month into 12 is equal to 2,400. And the rule for it is fully taxable. So keep it in the fully taxable column. Next one is city compensatory allowance. The rule is fully taxable and he has received 300 per month and 300 into 12 is equal to 3,600. It is fully taxable. The rule, you have to remember the rules. Without knowing the rules, you will not be able to do the problem. That is the most important part of direct taxation. Next one is research allowance. Already I told in the last class, this is a special allowance. There are six special allowances. And today in the numerical problem, I have taken one special allowance. So what is the rule? Actual received this much, actual spent this much, and whichever is low is exempted from tax, and over and above is fully taxable. So usko kitna mila? He has got 6,000 for the whole year. How much he has spent? 3,000. So this is exempted. 3,000 is exempted. So 6,000 mein se 3,000 exempted hai. So sorry, 6,000 mein se 3,000 exempted hai. 6,000 mein se 3,000 exempted hai. Because usko mila kitna? Itna. Kitna kharcha kiya? Itna. So difference kitna hai? 3,000. So it is fully taxable. So if you add all this, you will get 1,52,000. That is gross salary. Now, one part we could not do is this one. So in the next slide, we will see how this is calculated. So I think this you have cleared. This all things are cleared. Now I will clear how to calculate HRA. So we will see how HRA is calculated in the next slide. You can go. So HRA. So HRA also I have worked out for you. So he is residing in Mumbai. The rule for Mumbai is 50% of salary. 50% of salary. Next, this is rule number one. This is rule number one. Rule number two is actual HRA received. Rule number three is rent paid minus 10% of salary. So you should know the rules. Otherwise, you will not be able to do the problem. This is the most important aspect of income tax. So 50% of salary. Next one is actual HRA received. Number three is rent paid minus 10% of salary. So if you calculate all 1, 2, 3, you will come to know which is the lowest and that is exempted from tax. Let's see. So now here you are having a word salary. Here also you are having a word salary. So salary kya hota hai? Salary for the purpose is, salary for the purpose of calculation of HRA is, again, this is a rule. This rule has to be by hearted or you should know it. Otherwise you will not be able to do. HRA for the salary for the purpose of calculation of HRA is basic salary plus DA. If DA is forming a part of retirement benefit plus commission, whatever commission you have received. So in the previous slide, all these were there. Basic salary plus DA plus HRA. So basic salary is the basic salary is here. You can look. Okay, we will go to the previous slide and then we can see. So basic salary is 48,000. Commission is 10,000 and the DNS allowance is 24,000 because 24,000 is going into the calculation of retirement benefit. So 48,000 plus 24,000 plus 10,000. So look at this. So here for the purpose of calculation of HRA, what I did, I took 48,000 plus 24,000 plus commission of 10,000. So wherever there is a word, commission, wherever there is a word salary, you have to substitute them with this one, basic salary plus DA plus commission. So basic salary is how much? So just now I have calculated 48,000 from the previous slide. DA was 24,000 and this was commission was 10,000, 1 lakh into 10 lakhs into 1%. So this is what I have written here, 48,000, 24,000 and 10,000. So if you total it, you will get 82,000 rupees. So wherever there is a salary, you have to calculate, you have to replace salary with 82,000 for the purpose of calculation of DA. Okay, now let's calculate it. So salary 50%. So already we have calculated salary for this is 82,000. So 82,000 ka 40, 82,000 ka 50% aake, 82,000 into 50% is 41,000 rupees. So first calculation is done. Good. Next one is actual HRA received. So in the problem, it was given that actual HRA received by the employee from the employer was 1,000 rupees. So 1,000 into 12, 12,000 rupees. So you got first calculation, you got second calculation. Now third calculation, rent. See this subject you can only do if you know the rules on your tongue by heart. That's the reason it's a very difficult subject. If you don't know the rules, you will not be able to do it. So it requires a lot of hard work to do this kind of a subject. Okay. So without rules, you are gone. So for the last 15 years, I have been teaching this subject. So I know the rules. Whenever you ask me in the midnight also, I will be able to answer. So without knowing the rules, you will not be able to do like other subjects. It's theoretical or something like that. But this is rule. Rule should be by heart. Next one is the third condition. Rent paid minus 10% of salary. Rent paid minus 10% of salary. So rent paid. Usne ghar bhaade ke upar liya. To makan malik ko bhaada de raha. Kitna de raha hai? 1200 per month. In the last slide we have seen. 1200 per month into 12 months is equal to something like 14,400 is the rent paid by the employee to the owner. Next one is 10% of salary. Already we have calculated salary. Salary for the purpose is 82,000. So 82,000 ka 10% calculate karo, 8200 aayega. So 14,400 mein se ye nikal do, to ye figure aayega. So this is the third figure, 6,200. So how many calculations you have done? This calculation you have done, this calculation you have done, and this calculation you have done. So among them, whichever is lowest, you have to find out. This is one you got, this is one you got, and this is one you got. Among them, whichever is lowest. So the lowest is 6,200. This is exempted from tax. So these calculations were done to find out the exemption amount from HRA. So this is exempted. This is exempted. Now, how much is taxable? Taxable ka rule kya hai? Received minus exempted. Now, how much he received HRA? HRA he received was 12,000 rupees. 12,000 rupees. And how much was exempted? 6,200 was exempted because the lowest of the three calculations. So, how much is taxable? 12,000 minus 6,200 is 5,800. So this is taxable. So this amount should be carry forward in the taxable column. So we will see this. Aya either 5,800. So yes, you got it. So the amount has to be here. We have placed it. So this is the way you have to calculate HRA. So hope this problem is done. So once you have done all this, what you have to do? You have to add 1, 2, 3, 4, because this is taxable, 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 this is taxable. All taxable items have been kept under one column and you total it. And if I'm correct, it is 1,58,2,800. And you know the rule. The rule is up to 2.5 lakhs, nothing is taxable. So the tax as far as income on salary is concerned is zero. So this is the problem you can expect in your examination. Okay, now let's look at some more rules. Very, very important. Now today we are going to talk about some important things. Number one is entertainment allowance. Number two is professional tax. And number three is standard deduction. Very important. Please pay attention. It's very, very important. Okay, we'll do this. Now let's look at the problem. So this particular problem has got standard deduction to be found out. Number one, number two, entertainment allowance, how much it is going to be taxable. And number three is professional tax. Okay, so we will look at the rules and we will look at the problem also, and we will solve the problem. So let's look at the problem, because after we look into the problem and then we, if we solve it, it will be easy for us. But remember the figures. Now Mr. Rajesh is there. His age is 48 years. He's a government employee. So these three data is in front of you. He's Rajesh. He's a government employee, central government employee. He's 48 years old, and he's working in a central government employment. Now the basic salary is 40,000 rupees. So basic salary is 40,000 rupees. You can note down also simultaneously. DNS allowance is rupees 15,000. Commission is rupees 10,000. So please remember, basic salary is per month. DNS allowance is per month. Commission is for the whole year. So I have not written per month here, because commission is can't be given per month. It is calculated per year. If it is given this much, then only for the whole year. If it is written per month, then you have to calculate per month. Next one is entertainment allowance provided by the employee to the employer is 500 rupees per month. 500 rupees per month. So we have seen basic salary is there, DA is there, commission is there, entertainment allowance is there, and then professional tax. Now, if you are doing a profession, you have to pay tax. We will not go into the details of it, but just remember professional tax is there, and he is paying professional tax because it is a kind of a tax. He is paying for the year 2000 rupees. And please remember, rupees 4000 out of this was paid by the employer. Usko pay karna tha professional tax 2000. Usme se uska khud ke job mein se kitna pay kiya usne 1000 rupees for the full year. Aur employer ne, owner ne kitna pay kiya uska jo जिम्मेदारी था जो 2000 था उसमें से 1000 एम्प्लॉयर ने पे किया. सो 1000 एम्प्लॉय ने पे किया, 1000 एम्प्लॉयर ने पे किया. नाउ डिटरमाइन द इनकम फ्रॉम द सैलरी फॉर द असेसमेंट ईयर 2020-21 ऑफ राजेश इफ इज अ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉय एंड ए गाय विद 48 इयर्स ओल्ड. नाउ लेट्स डू द प्रॉब्लम. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम एंड इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट to know the rules and regulations. So I think you remember the figures. Just I will start doing the problem. Now the problem is like this. The problem is like this. Basic salary. So already we have seen he is receiving 40,000 per month. So this is per month column into 12 is equal to 480,000. Number one. So what is the rule for basic salary? Fully taxable. So this is the seventh or eighth time we are saying. Now it is by heart to you. By heart to you. Next one is DNS allowance. Now DNS allowance, the rule is fully taxable. How much is receiving? 15,000 per month into 12 is equal to 180,000. So these calculations are easy, no problem. Next one is commission. This is not per month, it is for the full year. So directly I have skipped this because this is not required, and the rule is fully taxable. That amount I have taken it in the taxable column amount. Next one is entertainment allowance. Now entertainment allowance ka first rule kya hai? In case of a government employee, private employee, it is fully taxable. Private employee ke isme it is fully taxable. There is no exemption. But in case of a, again I am repeating, very important, entertainment allowance, private employee hai, it is fully taxable. But in this case, this guy is a government employee, so this is not connected with him. So what is the rule for a government employee as far as entertainment allowance is concerned? Government employee ke liye rule kya hai? Idhar dekho, niche likha hai, 1, 2, 3 rules hai. These are three rules. So ye three rules pehle baad mein dekhenge. First aake kya karenge, in case of a government employee, first it is treated as fully taxable and shown in the salary, taxable salary, in the gross salary. A gross salary may include kiya jata hai. So I have included that 500 per month into 12 is equal to 6000. I have kept it here. It is fully taxable, consider kar raha hu. So first and foremost, you have to show the whole amount, whatever it has, he has received, as in the fully taxable column. So 500 into 12, I considered this as fully taxable. So I have considered this. Next one is professional tax paid by the employer. Whatever is the professional tax paid by the employer, you have to take into account. So this is 1000 rupees. So you add it. So 1000 rupees you have add. This is taxable because ये किसका जिम्मेदारी था? ये किसका जिम्मेदारी था? Employee का खर्चा था. This is the professional tax of employee. And who is paying it? Employer. So whatever is the professional tax of the employee paid by the employer, it is fully taxable. Please remember, this is also comes under perquisite. But for the time being, I will disregard it. But the rule says that ये किसका खर्चा है? ये professional tax किसका है? Employee का है. कौन pay कर रहा है? किसकी जिम्मेदारी है pay करने का? Employee का. क्यों pay? कौन pay कर रहा है? Employer कर रहा है. कितना pay कर रहा है? 1000 rupees. तो वो fully taxable है. तो वो fully taxable है. इधर डाल दिया. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I will add it. This is called as gross salary. Because from gross salary, there are some deductions. Some deductions. We'll see those deductions one by one. Now, first one is standard deduction. Ye by default rehta hai. By default, to a salaried person, the government is giving a standard deduction from salary of 50,000 rupees. Koi bhi rehne do. उसको गवर्नमेंट कितना डिडक्शन दे रहा है? स्टैंडर्ड डिडक्शन. द स्टैंडर्ड डिडक्शन अंडर सेक्शन 16, ये 16 के नीचे है, तीन है, 16 के नीचे जो डिडक्शंस की बातें कर रहे हैं, द डिडक्शंस व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, देयर आर थ्री डिडक्शंस, 1, 2, and 3. फर्स्ट वन इज स्टैंडर्ड डिडक्शन, सेकेंड वन इज एंटरटेनमेंट अलाउंस, थर्ड वन इज प्रोफेशनल टैक्स. सो 1, 2, and 3 आर द डिडक्शंस अंडर सेक्शन 16. Section 16 of Income Tax Act 1961. So one by one we will see. So standard deduction. So for the financial year 2019-20 or for the assessment year 2021, the standard deduction from salary only. This is from salary only. Salary के नीचे आपको straight away standard deduction कितना मिलता है? 50,000. तो ये मैंने इधर डाल दिया. I have deliberately shown this as yellow color. This yellow color why? These are all deductions. डिडक्शंस बोले तो इनकम टैक्स में से, इनकम में से इतना डिडक्ट कर लो, तो इतना डिडक्ट करने वाला हूं, माइनस करने वाला हूं, लेस. नेक्स्ट वन इज, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द एंटरटेनमेंट एलिमेंट्स. सो हियर आई हैव टेकन दिस इन फुल्ली टैक्सेबल कॉलम, बट दिस एज इज अ गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉई, बट द रूल सेज दैट एंटरटेनमेंट एलिमेंट्स इज पार्टली टैक्सेबल. एंटरटेनमेंट एलिमेंट्स इज पार्टली टैक्सेबल. तो इधर आपको कैलकुलेट करना है, पार्टली टैक्सेबल है. किसके लिए है? एक गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉय के लिए. वही अगर प्राइवेट एम्प्लॉय है तो फुल्ली टैक्सेबल है. इधर कुछ नहीं आएगा. सो व्हाट आर दिस रूल्स? एंटरटेनमेंट अलाउंस फॉर ए गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉय का रूल क्या है? नंबर वन इज अलाउंस रिसीव्ड. ऑलरेडी मैंने बताया इतना मिल रहा है तो मैंने ये ले लिया, अलाउंस रिसीव्ड, एंटरटेनमेंट अलाउंस रिसीव्ड. नेक्स्ट वन इज 1/5 ऑफ द बेसिक सैलरी. सेकंड कैलकुलेशन, दिस इज द फर्स्ट कैलकुलेशन, this is a second calculation. What is the second calculation? 1/5 of basic salary. 1/5 of basic salary. Basic salary kitna hai? 4,80,000. 1/5 bole to 20%. 1/5 or 20% are one and the same. So 4,80,000 mein se 20% calculate karo, 96,000. So the second calculation is 96,000. So you got 96,000. First calculation is actual HR, actual entertainment allowance received. Number one. Number two is basic salary ka 20% or 1/5. So 4,80,000 into 1/5 or 4,80,000 into 20%, 96,000. So second calculation also is done. Next one is statutory amount. Bole to income tax department ne kitna exemption diya hai? Maximum itna exemption diya hai, 5,000 rupees. So statutory means by law you get an exemption of 5,000 rupees. So you got now three calculations. Number one, number two, number three, rule for entertainment allowance in case of a government employee. तो इसमें से जो भी lowest है वो कितना है? 5,000. This is the lowest. That is exempted from tax. This is the lowest. This is exempted from tax. तो this is exempted from tax. जो भी इधर है exempted है वो इधर डाल दो. क्यों बोले तो इधर plus किया था, हम लोग इधर minus कर रहे. This is minus and this is minus. So this is understood. This is understood. Now the third deduction. The third deduction is section and 13, section 1, section 2, section 3. Now section 3, subsection 16 ke niche subsection 3 is professional tax paid. Jo bhi professional tax employer or employee ne pay kiya hai, wo pura ka pura exemption milega. So this is one exemption, this is one exemption, and this is one exemption. So salary kitna tha? 7,09,000. 7,09,000 mein se 50,000 ek nikal do, 5,000 ek nikal do, aur 2,000 ek nikal do. Sab mila ke 57,000 nikal do. 57,000 nikal do. To aayega 7,09,000 mein se 57,000 nikal diya, you will get 6,52,000 as income from salary. So how beautiful this problem is. Have you understood? So if you don't know the rules, if you don't know the rules, you can't do anything. That is the basic fundamental of this subject. So remembering rules is very important, and it's a very difficult subject. I'm telling you, for the last 15 years I'm teaching you, till today also I'm preparing. So it, whereas the other subjects, once you are taught, you can't need not look at them. But this subject, every year there are changes in the rule. So you have to keep on looking at the rules and incorporate those rules. For example, in the last class, I made a small mistake. Traveling allowance, I told like for a handicap, it is 1600 per month. But there is a change in the financial year 2019-20 or assessment to 2020-21 that it has been hiked to from 1600 per month to 3200 per month. So I committed a mistake. Why? Because I have to read. And if you don't read, you will not be able to do the problem. You will not able to compute the salary income or income from income tax, income from salary or income from house property. So rules are very important, and this subject requires lot of hard work, lot of sincerity, and lot of dedication, and the willingness to teach and willingness to learn. So this is the income. Now how much tax he has to pay, we'll see. So he got an income of 6,52,000. Let's see how much tax he has to pay. Let's see. So we'll see this. So now this is the slide. So his income is 6,52,000. This is his income is 6,52,000. His age is 48. So I told in the very first class or second class, the rules are like this. The rules are like this. Up to income of 2.5 lakhs, nothing is taxable. From 2.5 lakhs to 5 lakhs, 5%. From 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, it is 20%. And from above 10 lakhs, it is 30%. So already I told. Now, in the last slide, we have seen that the total income of this person from income from salary, assuming that there are no deductions, no income from other sources like income from house property or business or capital gains or income from other source, and no deductions and exemptions further, I am assuming that this is the taxable salary. So iske upar isko tax pay karna hai. Abhi tax itna to pay nahi karna hai na, ye to income ho gaya na, income itna ho gaya, abhi is income ke upar kitna tax pay karna hai. So based upon this I have done my calculations. This ye ek rule hai, ye rule agar pata nahi hai, then you will not be able to do. So you know the, you should know the tax slabs, and every year the tax slabs keeps on changing. Please remember that. So what I did, 6,52,000 ko maine kya kiya, four parts mein divide kar diya. First 2.5 lakhs, 2.5 lakhs, next 2.5 lakhs, next 2.5 lakhs, next 5 lakhs. 5 lakhs to itna income nahi hai, jo baki hai isme aayega. Aur fourth slab mein kuch bhi nahi hai, because his income is within 10 lakh rupees, so it will, this will not come. So I have kept it as zero. Now the tax rates on this one, 0%, 5%, 20%, and 30%. So 2.5 lakhs ke upar 0% is 0, 2.5 lakhs ke upar 5% is 12,500, 1,52,000 ke upar 20% agar calculate karunga, to 30,400, 0 ke upar 30%, because in the third, fourth slab his income is 0, and 30% calculate karunga to 0. Now this he has to pay, this he has to pay, this he has to pay, this he has to pay. So what I did, I just totaled it. 12,500 plus 30,400 is 42,500 tax pay karna. 42,500 tax pay karna. Hope this is very useful. So look at this. On an income of 6,52,000, on an income of 6,52,000, he has to pay 42,500 as tax. So the story doesn't end here. The story is still continuing. on this 42,500, on this 42,500, still he has to pay 3% towards education cess, secondary and higher education cess, and 1% for health cess. So I will calculate total it is 4%. So 4% he is there, he is calculated on this, not on this. No, it is calculated on 4% is calculated on this one. If you calculate on 4% on this one, it will be 24,000. It's wrong. So you have to calculate that 4% on this particular amount. So if I calculate it, it is 42,900 into 4% is equal to 1716. So you have to pay this, you have to pay this. And if you total, your income tax liability is 44,600. Your income tax liability is 44,600. So look here, on an income of 6,52,000. Now, please remember, you have to pay almost like 12% to 13% as tax. India mein tax rate jyada hai. On income of, it is 7%, near about 7% tax you have to pay. 6,52,000 ke upar roughly ye calculate karunga to 7%. So you have to pay tax of near about on 6,52,000, 44,616, which is almost 7%. So it is a very big amount. So hope you understood two problems today. Now we are going to talk about the next topic, which is retirement benefits. So the topic for the day is again, income from salary from retirement benefits. So after you have worked for 30 years, you are going to retire. So when you're retiring, you will not, from a retirement day till you die, you will not be having any income. So what you do, all these 30 years, you are very foresighted. So provident means foresighted. Foresighted bole to bhavishya ke bare mein sochta hai. To isi tarah se kya hota hai, aapko company wale bhi retirement benefits dete. What are these retirement benefits? There are three retirement benefits which you will get from the employer during the employment, on the day of retirement or after the retirement or during the retirement period. What are those? One is leave encashment. Very important. Again, there are rules. Very, very important rules are there. This subject is full of rules. And I know the rules on my fingertips. That is my hard work I have done. So without hard work, you can't achieve anything. Without hard work, you will not be able to achieve anything. So be sincere to yourself. Then only you can do some justice to your life. So hard work, sincerity, daily study, open the textbook, do problems and do practicals. So leave encashment is one. I will tell you about that in the next. Next one is gratuity. And third one, you popularly know pension. You popularly know that after retirement, you will get something called as pension. So again, I'm repeating, you will get at the time of retirement or during the period of retirement, three things from the employer, leave encashment. And I think you have just able to understand what is leave encashment. Next one is gratuity. And number three is pension. Now, please remember, again, pension is divided into two: commuted pension and uncommuted pension. So next one is what this, all this, we have to divide the employees into government employee and non-government employee. So for government employee, the rule will be different. For a non-government employee, the rule will be different. So many rules. Yes, you have to, because a chartered accountant will earn more. Why? Because he has knowledge. He has worked hard. He has worked for four years for 24 hours. And once he's having knowledge, he's capitalizing on that. So without knowledge, if you assume that you can conquer the world, no. Now let's look at the first one. So let's look at the first one. The first one is gratuity. The gratuity is nothing but, see, very important again, gratuity is nothing but, I will explain it to you. See, celebrating Teachers Day on September 5th. Hopefully, if everything is okay and this coronavirus goes away, probably you will celebrate Teachers Day. You will invite all the teachers. You will felicitate them. You will be happy to share whatever you are because of the teacher. So what is the meaning? The meaning is gratitude. You are showing gratitude towards a teacher because whatever you are today, gratitude, whatever you are today, it's because of teacher. Now, in the same way, when I'm talking about gratuity, the word gratuity is derived from the word gratitude. Now, who is gratitude to whom? Who is grateful to whom? The employer or the owner is grateful to the employee because the employee has worked for 30 or 40 or 25 years and today is retiring. Today the employee is retiring. The company never ends, but the employee will retire. So today the employer will give him, he will show gratitude in the form of a lump sum amount. Lump sum amount will be given. Lump sum amount. Now, first and foremost, what is this lump sum amount and what is this? So we will find out that. So let's understand, gratuity is the payment made by the employer to an employee in appreciation of the past services. Past services ke hisab se wo kuch paisa deta hai, lump sum amount deta hai. Lump sum amount deta hai. It is received by the employee on the retirement. Please remember, this is not during the service time. Gratuity is paid at the time of retirement only. If it is paid during the service, it is fully taxable. Next one is, for the purpose of the exemption, employees are categorized into three categories. We'll see what is this. So government employee and employees of local authority. So first category is government employee and employee of local authority. So government employee mein kaun kaun rehta hai? Central government rehta hai, state government rehta hai, quasi government bolke ek hai, and local authorities. Local authority means municipal, PCMC, PMC, Pune Municipal Corporation, or PCMC, Pimpri-Chinchwad Municipal Corporation, or municipal corporation. Uske under kaam kar rahe hai, to local authorities hai. So unke liye rule kya hai? What is the rule for them? If the employee is receiving gratuity at the time of retirement, in the case of government employee and non-government employee, any amount is exempted from tax. Look at this. Agar government उस एम्प्लॉई को अगर 50 लाख भी दे दिया, फुल्ली एग्जेम्प्टेड है, इसको एक पैसा भी इसके ऊपर टैक्स पे करने की जरूरत नहीं है अंडर द इनकम सैलरी. अगर 10 लाख भी मिल गया, एग्जेम्प्टेड है. अगर 5 लाख भी मिल गया तो भी एग्जेम्प्टेड. जीरो भी मिल गया, एग्जेम्प्टेड है. 1 करोड़ भी मिल गया, एग्जेम्प्टेड है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वन ऑफ माई स्टूडेंट फ्रेंड वॉज टेलिंग दट आई एम टेकिंग वॉलंटरी रिटायरमेंट, आई एम गोइंग टू गेट 50 लाख रुपीज एज ग्रेच्युटी. And he's working in border. So he's a government employee, central government employee. So it is 50 lakhs mila. Uske upar agar hum log calculation karenge to 15 lakh ka tax pay karna hai. Lekin isko kuch bhi pay nahi karna hai because he's a government employee. So today's code is, you can remember, today's code is 508. So please remember, in case of a non-government employee, the rule is different. In case of a government employees will not be taxed because government ही tax collect करके government को pay करेगा क्या? Government अपने लोगों से government employees से tax pay collect करेगा और अपने पास रखेगा क्या? No, that's the reason it is fully exempted from tax. Okay, so tomorrow again we are going to start with from here I will continue and we are going to talk about retirement benefits. So don't miss tomorrow's class. It's very important. We are going to talk about gratuity. Government employee, non-government employee, pension, that is commuted pension and uncommuted pension, and leave encashment. What are the rules for government?